Good morning, students. So, in the last class, we discussed the binomial expansion. In that, we discussed one example that if x is very much less than 1, suppose 1 plus x whole power n is there, if x is very much less than 1 means, then how you wrote this one? 1 plus x whole power n you wrote as 1 plus nx. And using this, we discussed a few examples also. Now, we are going to discuss that how we use generally in physics. One example will be discussing. What is that example here is, suppose the variation of g with height. So g in the sense gravitational acceleration. So the gravitational acceleration is going to be changed if you go from surface to certain height. So how it is going to be changed, just we can discuss it. Suppose if it is a planet Earth, if you taken, this is Earth, if you taken, on the surface of Earth, it is a g. This g expression is g capital M by r square, where g is universal gravitational constant, that is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Here M is the mass of the Earth, r is the radius of Earth. So here g is a universal gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant, and M mass of Earth or planet we can write, and R radius of Earth or any planet. This is the value of G on the surface. If you go to a certain height from the surface h, if you go to a height h, at this point the gravitational acceleration is g at height h equal to, actually here from center to the surface is radius r. That's why on the surface means g value you wrote as gm by r square. From center to height h means totally how much distance is there from center? R plus h. That's why g at height h is, we can write as a g m by, here only distance going to be changed. Here it is r because on the surface. At a height h means it will be r plus h whole square. So g equal to gm by r square on the surface, gh is equal to gm by r plus h whole square at a height h. Now we want the relation between these two. Well, we can write gh by g equal to, so division if you take it, so gm by r plus h whole square divided by gm by r square. So gm is common, it is going to be cancelled. Now it will be 1 by r plus h whole square by 1 by r square means it is a reciprocal, it will becomes r square by r plus h whole square. This I will write like this, gh by g equal to, this r if I brought it in the denominator, it has a square, no? That's why you can write this as r plus h by r whole square. Then 1 by 1 plus h by r whole square, because if you separate it, r by r means 1, h by r. Then this 1 plus h by r whole square, if you take into the numerator, this 1 plus h by r if you take into the numerator, then what is going to happen here? G h by g equal to 1 plus
h by r whole raised to minus 2. This is just like 1 plus x whole power n. Height h, r is the radius of r. Height h equal to, if it is you taken 100 meters or 200 meters like that, otherwise 1 kilometer like that if you taken almost 1 kilometer if you taken. R is radius of r. R is radius of r means r equal to radius of r, that is 6400. Radius of r, that is 6400 kilometers. Then h by re, h by re, that is 1 by 6400 means this is very much less than 1 or not. So the condition is satisfied. 1 plus x whole power n type is there. And this x is very much less than 1. Then 1 plus x whole power n is there and x is very much less than 1 means what you can write? 1 plus nx. That's why 1 plus n means here minus 2. Therefore, I will write like this, gh by g equal to 1 plus nx. N means minus 2 x in the sense, h by r, this is 1 minus 2h by r. Then g at a height h equal to g on the surface into 1 minus 2h by r. So this is the variation of g with height. So here what we used, this is the term is came like this. This term we simplified in this way by using which one? This 1 plus x whole power n is equals to 1 plus nx, the binomial expansion only we used and we simplified this one. Like this, in many cases, this approximation means if x is very much less than 1 means we are going to be right. So 1 plus x whole power n, if x is very much less than 1 means we are going to be right that as 1 plus nx. This is one example we shown what we used in physics. In the same way, in many cases we use this kind of example. Okay. So next we are going to be discuss the another concepts that is sequence and series. Next one, which is sequence and series. So what is a sequence and what is a series we'll be discussing. First one, sequence. So sequence means it is a set of numbers which are written in a what particular order. So sequence is a set of numbers which are written in a particular order. For example, you take it like this, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on like this. So 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on like this is there. You see the order here, 1, after adding some 2, 3, after adding some 2, 5, after adding 2, 7, after adding 2, 9 like this. They are in a order, in a particular order. So this can be written like this or not. Here, 2n minus 1. So this is, you can write as a 2n minus 1 series, where n equal to what? 1, 2, 3 and so on. If you substitute 1, 2 into 1 minus 1, so 2 minus 1, 1. If you substitute 2, 2 to the 4 minus 1, 3. If you substitute 3, 2 to the 6 minus 1, 5. If you substitute 4, like that this one will come. So, a sequence means it is a set of numbers which are written in a particular order. So, we can write like that, sequence is a set of numbers which are written in a, which are written in a particular order. So that is we can say. For example, Here in this series 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 is there. This is what we can call first term. Like that we have nth term, second term, third term. Like that we can write nth term. For example, we can take one series. So let you can go for the a series 2n plus 2 is there. So write the first 5 terms of this series. Write the first 5 terms of this series means write the first 5 terms of this series means what you can write first 5 terms in the sense first you have to substitute n equal to 1, 2, 3 like that. So n equal to 1 if you substitute you will get first n equal to 1, next n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. Then what are the series here? 2, 1 plus 2. So that is what? 4. Next, 2 plus 2, 6. Next, 2 into 3 plus 2, 8. 2 into 4 plus 2, 10. 2 into 5 plus 2, 12. So these are the 5 numbers of this 2n plus 2 series. Like that if they ask you, for example you write like this. You write, an example you can do like write like this. Examples, write the series of, write the first 5 terms of minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n. I am asking you this one. Write the first 5 terms of minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This one is 1. And second one like that, I am going to give you that. Write the first 5 terms of, so 2n minus 3 by 2, or else you can take like this, 3n minus 2 by 2. So 3n minus 2 by 2. First 5 times they ought to be right. So these are the examples you can solve it. So next one. Series. What is the series means? Series is something which is obtained from the sequence by summing, by taking the summation of all the numbers together. For example, you have the sequence like this. What is the sequence means? I am going to take 1, 3, or else 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on like this here. So, first term, second term, third term, fourth term like this. So, if you take the summation of, if I want it, S3 is a summation of first 3 terms, that is 1 plus 3 plus 5. Like that S2 means summation of first 2 terms, that is 1 plus 3. So here 9, here 4. Means a series is something which is obtained from sequence by adding the sum of all the terms together. So that is we can write like this. So series is something which is obtained from sequence. Something which is obtained from sequence. How we are obtaining this? By adding the what? All the numbers together. Obtained from sequence by
adding the all the numbers together. For example, I have a series like this. For example, I have a series like this. 4, 2, 0, minus 2, minus 4. So I have a sequence in this way. So in this sequence, I want to find. So find, if I ask, find S2, S3, S5. So find S2, S3 and S5 means, so we have to find the series of this sequence, summation. S2 means summation of the two numbers. S3 means summation of the first three terms. S5 means summation of the first five. Then if you do that one, S2 in the sense, summation of the first two, that is 4 plus 2, that is equal to 6. And S3 means summation of the first three, that is S3 equal to 4 plus 2 plus 0, that is 6. And S5 is the summation of first 3, that is 4 plus 2 plus 0 minus 2 minus 6. That is totally how much it will be? 4 plus 2 plus 0 minus 2 minus 4, that is 0. Like this we can take the series means, which is obtained from the sequence by adding all those numbers. So in the series we have an arithmetic progression as well as the geometric progression we usually use in physics. So those two things we are going to discuss it now. See, in this first one, arithmetic progression. The arithmetic progression is a sequence. So in which the new term, how can we obtain the every new term is by adding a constant term to the preceding one. So arithmetic progression is a sequence in which how the sequence will be there means for the first one if you add a constant, then next one will come. Again for the next one, again the same constant if we add, you will get the next one like that. Suppose if you have a first term is A, if you have a first term is A, and the second term you are getting by adding a constant, that is A plus B. Again, if you are adding the same constant D for it, you will get, if you add a D for it, you will get A plus 2D. Again, if you add same constant D for it, you will get the A plus 3D and so on. So what you can write here, a D is commonly we are adding for everywhere. A D is commonly we are adding. So this D is called as the common difference. So what we are going to be add every time from the preceding one, that is we can call it as a what? Common difference. Here the constant what we are adding, the constant what we are adding to the preceding one is called common difference, is called common difference D. So what you can write is AP is a arithmetic progression is a sequence in which the new term, how you are obtaining the new term? The new term is obtained by adding a constant D. What is that we call? Common difference to the preceding one. Common difference to the preceding one. To the preceding one. So in such a way, if the sequence is there, then we can call that as a what? It is in arithmetic progression.
If you take the arithmetic progression like a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d and on, if you go for the nth term, what is there here is, if you go for the nth term, we can write like this. Here, like this, if you go on, if you take the nth term will be a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is first term, second term, and this is the nth term. Therefore, the nth term they want to ask. So in AP, nth term, that is Tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, where a is called first term, a is first term, and d is the common difference. D is a common difference here. So, like that we have. For example, if you have a series like this, so 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on, find the 20th term, find the 20th term, like this if it is go on, the sequence is going on, find the 20th term if I ask you, here how it is there? It is in a sequence. And here what is that? First term T1 equal to 2. And the second term T2 equal to 4. And the common difference. How can we get the common difference? Means second term minus first term. Common difference D equal to T2 minus T1. That is equal to 4 minus 2, 2. Common difference is 2. Now, what is first term here? 2. That is, we can write as a equal to first term T1. That is 2. So, we have A and we have D also. Then, nth term. How can you find the nth term? The formula for nth term is A plus N minus 1 into D. So A plus 1 minus N into D means T. Which number you want it here? 20th term. So T 20 is equals to A. A means we have 2 plus N minus 1. N minus 1 means N here how much? N here 20. So 20 minus 1 into D. D is common difference 2. That is 2 plus 19 minus 20 minus 1, 19, 19 into 2, 38. So 38, that is equivalent to 40. So 20th term is nothing but here 40. Like that we can obtain. So in the same way, if you want to take the summation, of all these terms, so I can take the sum of the n terms of AP. Sum of the n terms of AP we can write like this. Here I am going to write that. If the terms are like this, if it is there. See. Sum of n terms of AP arithmetic progression, observe A plus A plus D plus A plus 2D plus and so on A plus N minus 1 into D. The sum of N terms, we have a formula. Sum of N terms means we have Sn equal to, Sn is equals to, so what you can write, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, where n is the how many terms we are going to take it. If you want to add 10 terms, n plus 10. If you want 20 terms, n plus 20, like that. And a is the first term and d is the common difference, you know. So in that way you can take it. For example, if you are taken, suppose is the same example I am going to take it, 1, the sequence is there, no, like this, 1, 3, 3, 5, 7, and so on, there like this. And the sum of the, I am going to take 9, 11, and so on. So sum of the first 5 terms if you want it. So sum of the 5 terms means you can have like this, sum of the 5 terms. Sum of the 6 terms you take it, sum of the 6 terms. So sum of the 6 terms means, so they are in A, commonly what we are added? 2, commonly is 2 we are added here. So A is the first term, A equal to 1. And what is the common difference here between 3 and 2, 5 and 3, 7 and 5, common difference is 2. So common difference is 2. So D equal to 2. And we want it, sum of the n terms means 6 terms we want it. So n equal to here 6. N equal to 6. Then if you substitute S6 equal to, what you can write? S6 equal to 6 by 2. 2 into A is 1 plus N minus 1. 6 minus 1 into common difference is 2. That is 3 into 2 plus 6 minus 1, 5 into 2 is 10. So 12. 12 into 3 is 36. So 36 here. We can observe here. 4, 9. Okay, 9, 16. 16 plus 9, 25. 25 plus 11, 36. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We directly add and directly we can take. So we will get the result the same. So this is the sum of what n terms in the if. Like that, we can go for the next one. Geometric progression. So now, geometric progression. So geometric progression is a one kind of sequence. So in which the new term can be obtained after the first by multiplying the constant term of the preceding one. By multiplying the constant term by the preceding one. Say, for example, if you take A, and we can get the second term, the next term, by multiplying a constant with this first term A. That is, I am writing as AR. So I multiply with what? R. Similarly, if I want to get the second term, so I have to multiply with one more time R. That is A R into R, R square. Next, if I multiply with another one more time R, so A R cube and so on. Means here, every time I am multiplying with R or not? So every time I am multiplying with R, then I am getting the new term. So how can you say the geometric progression is? Geometric progression is a sequence. A geometric progression is a sequence in which we can obtain the new term by multiplying a constant term with the preceding one. Okay. So we can see like this. So GP is a sequence in which GP is a sequence in which we can obtain So a GP is a sequence in which we can obtain a new term. After the first, what? How we are doing that? By multiplying the constant with the preceding one. First, by multiplying the constant R. Here R we can call it as a common ratio. We are multiplying with R. This R we can call it as a common ratio here. This R we can call as a common ratio. Common ratio with the preceding one. So with the preceding one. So this is K what? G. Where A is first term. Here this is first term T1. This is second term T2. And so on. So here first term is that is T1 equal to, we can write A. And common ratio. Common ratio we can find R by dividing the second term with the first term. So dividing the second term and first term, we will get the common ratio R. Then we can find the sum of the n terms. And here sum of infinite terms. Those two we can going to discuss it now. Let us, and how we can use this one in a physics also, we are going to discuss it here. Now if you observe, the sum of n terms of GP, that is A plus AR plus AR square plus and so on plus A r power n minus 1, like this is there. The sum of n terms equal to Sn equal to A into 1 minus r power n by 1 minus r, where r not equal to 1. Here common ratio should not be equivalent to 1. If it is equivalent to 1, what happens here? Sum is becomes to infinity, which is invalid. Because you know anything power, anything by 0, anything by 0 means it is a invalid. So we can say infinity. So that way r should not be equivalent to 1 here in this case. Suppose if you have the series like this, 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. So 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16 and so on. So how it is there here? 2 is there. So multiplied with 2, 4, multiplied with 2, 8, multiplied with 2, 16, like that it is came. And how these are arranged means you can say these are in, not in AP, it is in GP here. So in this, what is the first term? A equal to 2. What is the common ratio? R equal to T2 by T1. So T2 means second term 4 by first term 2, that is 2. And you want to find sum of some 10 terms like that. You want to find some sum of 10 terms like that. So I can write sum of 5 terms, you see, let us. So find the sum of 5 terms means. Find the sum of 5 terms means. Here the formula what we are going to take is Sn equal to A into 1 minus r power n by 1 minus r. So sum of 5 terms means S5 equal to, what is A here? 2 into 1 minus r. Common ratio is 2 power How many summation you wanted for 5 terms, no? So n is 5. So r is 2 power 5 by 1 minus r is 2. Then if you write 2 into 1 minus 2 power 5 is 32 by minus 1. So 1 minus 32 minus 31 by minus means minus 1 is going to be plus only. So 2 into 31, that is 62. So this is the what sum of the 5 terms of this what GP. So like that, if you have infinite terms, so we can find the sum of the infinite terms. How we can find? We can be check it now. So next, the sum of infinite terms. Like if you take S infinity of A plus AR plus AR square and so on, and the AR cube and so on up to infinite terms are there. The sum of these infinite terms is, we can write as a S infinity equal to A by 1 minus R. S infinity equal to A by 1 minus R, where R minus 1 you can take it when R is greater than 1, if R is less than 1, okay, 1 minus R you can take it. Here R is less than 1. Here R is less than 1. Otherwise you can write S infinity equal to A by R minus 1 when R is greater than 1. And this sum of infinite terms is very useful in physics. So how it is useful in physics, just you can take one example here. For suppose, I think you studied in the gravitation. So in gravitation, so in between any two masses, there is a gravitational force of attraction will be there. And you studied in the 10th standard. What is that? If two masses are there, if mass M1, here mass M2 is there. If they are separated by a certain distance, so what is the force between them here? Force between them is G into M1, M2 by R square or not? So G into M1, M2 by R square. So what is this? Is called force of gravitational force of attraction between two masses. So this is the formula is already known to you. So an example we can discuss like this, how this sum of infinity terms we are using in physics. So this formula already you know, so in 10th standard you studied. So one example we can take it now. So let us see one example here. Let us take the coordinate system. Take a coordinate system. So on x-axis, a mass m, on x-axis mass m, on x-axis an infinity, number of masses are arranged, at distance 1 meter, 2 meter, 4 meter, 8 meter and so on from origin. If same mass, m placed at origin
placed at origin. What is the force of attraction? What is the force of attraction by all these masses on the mass which is present at origin? Then force of attraction on this mass due to R. Just you can see like this. Let us have a coordinate system like this. Example we are going to take like this. So the coordinate system we can take as x and y axis. On x axis, each of an infinite number of mass, each of mass m. So each of mass m you take it. So an infinite number of masses are there, each of mass m. They arrange at where 1 meter, 2 meter, 4 meter, 8 meter from the origin. This is origin or not? From this origin, the masses 1 like this. Many they are kept like this. Under like this. So all are having, see, all are having infinite number of equal masses. Writing infinite number of equal mass m. So all are having mass m only. Up to what extent it is taken? Up to infinity. And where they located? They located at 1 meter, 2 meter, next 4 meter, next 8 meter, like that. And they mentioned the same mass. What kind of masses we are arranging? Same kind of mass they located at where? At origin. So they located the same kind of mass at the origin M. Yeah. And what happens? These all masses is trying to be attract this mass or not? What are the masses we located on this x axis? All masses will trying to be attract this mass. Then we can write. The first one is attracted by a force F1 towards it. Second one is attracted by a force F2. Third one is attracted by a force F3. Like that, all the forces are along the same direction. Then total force on this mass equal to what you can write. The total force on this mass is the total force on this mass we can write like this. What is that? Is F equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus F4 and so on. All these are in the same direction. Then what is the force between any two masses? What is the force between any two masses we have? Force between any two masses F equal to G M1 M2 by distance square between the masses. Distance how much is there? That distance square. You see first two. M1, M2 both are same. Distance how much? 1 meter square. So F1 means G. M1 is M. M2 also be M. So M1, M2 means M square by distance square means 1 square according to the formula. Second one. G. Next. This is M1 now. This is M2 now. So again what is that? M1, M2 both are same. M square. M1, M2 is M square by. What about the distance between these two masses here? So between these two masses is 2. So 2 square plus. Again, the next one. So between these two. Between these two is again M1, M2 both are equal masses. But distance is how much? 4 meters. So G M square by 4 square. Same way. Here these two same masses. Distance is 8 meters. G M square by 8 square. And so on up to infinity is there. Then F equal to G common I am taking, M square also common I am taking,
then how it is there? 1 by 1 square. So 1 by 1 square means 1 plus 1 by what? 2 square means 4 plus 1 by 4 square plus 1 by 8. 8 square 16. 8 square is 64. 64 you can write as a 1 by 4 cube or not. My 8 square is 64. Again you can write as a 4 cube. 4 into 4 16, 16 4 jar 64. And so on like this. Now up to what extent it was there? Up to infinity. Then this value you have to obtain it. Then problem will be solved. How can you obtain? How it is there? 1. And that 1 is multiplied by 1 by 4. Again that 1 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 4. Again that 1 by 4 square multiplied by 1 by 4. So in what kind of progression it is? This progression is geometric progression. Then what you can do now? Here, what is the first term? First you have to note it. And the sum of the infinite terms of GP. This is the sum of the infinite terms of GP. So I mean just now we discussed sum of infinite terms of GP. Formula is what? S infinity is equals to A by 1 minus R. So this complete summation is nothing but you can find by using this formula. So what about A? A is the first term. So A is the first term, that is A equal to 1. Next, common ratio. How can you find the common ratio? I am removing this one. Already you know what is the arrangement. Now what is the common ratio? That is second term by first term. Common ratio R equal to second term by first term. What is second term here? 1 by 4. What is first term here? 1. That is 1 by 4 only. Then S infinity equal to what you can write? A. A means 1. By 1 minus R means 1 by 4. Then it is, you can find. So 1 minus 1 by 4 means 1 by 3 by 4. That is 4 by 3. So completely you can remove it. Completely this can be removed. And completely in this place, because this is the summation, no? The summation completely, how much we have? The summation completely 4 by 3. Then if you write 4 by 3 in this total summation, then F equal to, total force F equal to G M square into, this is the sum of infinite terms, no? This completely can be replaced by 4 by 3. So we can write 4 by 3. G M square. So like this, we use the sum of infinite terms by finding the forces, by finding the electric field intensities, by finding the potentials. In many cases, we are using this formula in physics. Okay. So like this, we have few more cases which we use in physics. So those we will be discussing the next class. And if you have any doubts are there, definitely you can contact us directly. So my name is Durga Prasad, and 9035588228. So regarding any doubts are there, you can directly WhatsApp or else you can call, and there is definitely at any time we are available to clarify the doubts. Don't worry about it. Slowly in Kannada medium students also can understand easily. So all these basics if you learn properly, the physics is becomes easy for you. Okay. So if any doubts are there, you can contact me. Take care. We will start the next class in the some from few more concepts we will discuss in the next class. Take care. Bye.